I love being an actor. I love being in the arts. I love the type of people I know and the kind of work. I like the variety of being an actor. And what I learn about so many things in life through acting, through the different roles I've played. I guess one of the first really exciting theater productions that where things kind of fell into place was a version of Rocky Horror that I was involved in. We all worked really hard. We were all young and enthusiastic, and there was no egos going on there. We were all working together and supporting each other and just loving the whole process. It was only meant to run for a week, and the producers decided that they wanted to try and get the touring rights for it. So they kept us together and sent us out as a large band playing in some of the best clubs in the city. So that was a lot of fun too. For a few more weeks, we got to do that, and they never did secure the touring rights. So we didn't get to go any further than that, but it was quite a fun experience. I studied clown for quite a while in the city, for a good couple of years solidly. And my dream, I was studying from teachers that had studied at the Lecoq School in Paris. And my dream at the time was, you know, I could sell my house and go to Paris with my daughter and study there, and then maybe come back and work in a company that would be based on that type of work. And meanwhile, I lucked into an audition and got cast in a show with Theatre Beyond Words, so that saved me the step of having to go to Paris and back. And I was working with these fabulous people that I admired. When I was in university, some of them would come to teach workshops at the university, and I was blown away by their work. So I'm very honored to be part of that company. I did two different shows with them, so over about a year and a half, I worked with them quite a bit. As an older actor, I was cast in the musical Billy Elliot as the understudy for Grandma, and I also had an ensemble role that I did all the time when I wasn't on as Grandma. And to be cast in a musical as a dancer at an older age was quite exciting. I got to do the show here in Toronto. That was my absolute dream job, was working for the Mirvishes here in Toronto, doing, you know, a longer run than I had done in any regional theaters or any other play I had done before. And at the end of that, they invited me to join the touring company of the national touring company in the United States. So I actually stayed with that show for 2 years, traveling all around the States and some shows in Canada, and ending that tour in Brazil, which was very exciting. And now opened a new door for myself. There's a story that I've been wanting to tell for a long time. I wrote a little short film based on that idea, which was used for a workshop with the Toronto Actor Women's Committee. And the woman who led the workshop was a script editor who loved the story and really encouraged me to. She said, "This is a story that has to be told." I won an award, the Cale Tiernan Award, which was for development. And I'm blown away. Every time I kind of step back from it and doubt myself, something magical happens again that keeps me going in this direction. So it's something very exciting at this time in my life to be taking on something so new and different. I've never written a screenplay before, so just even the basics of learning what has to be done, it's a huge learning curve, but it's very exciting. And I guess I'd love to talk more, but I have to go home and learn how to play the accordion and prepare an audition for Saturday for a musical. And then on Thursday, I have to do a self-recording of for a voice audition, and yeah, just like it's busy. And I'm still going at it. And I think I'll just keep going until I drop, as long as they let me.